Thank you, Simon. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I'd like to introduce myself as Simon has pre-introduced ourselves as well. I'm Sukhendra. I'm being joined by one of my colleagues here, Asri. We are from a company called Envirosolutions Consulting, short form we call as ESC. We are actually an environmental, health, safety, social risk consulting company. We have been working in Indonesia for about the last 10 years or so. We are headquartered in Singapore, actually, but we have an office in Jakarta in the last 3 years. That's a short introduction about our company. Actually, we also have a bit of our company profile. We have a brochure that if you're interested to get one, you can get one from either me or Asri later on after the presentation. So, ESC, we have been working very closely with Better Work Indonesia in recent months and recent years, especially in introducing a new assessment cluster, which is an environmental aspect into the existing BWI assessment clusters. As you have probably understood pretty well, that under BWI, there have already been two clusters of assessment being in place, the social or the labor component, as well as the occupational health and safety. So what we have been working with Better Work Indonesia now is to establish a new assessment cluster under the environmental aspect. So we call it the BWI Environmental Cluster Assessment. As Simon has introduced earlier, that we have done some pilot assessment on this in recent months at three factories. So this presentation is going to introduce to you what the assessment is like, what is the scope of the assessment, how is this assessment different or getting similar to any other assessment available out there, including a comparison between this assessment with proper program, which was previously introduced by Sigit, and also a comparison between this assessment with another assessment out there, which is currently being done under SAC, or called the HIC Index. So the assessment scope of the BWI Environmental Cluster Compliant is redesigned pretty much similar to any other assessment out there. You can name it in any environmental parameters that you can find when we want to do environmental assessment or environmental audit. So we actually developed 11, we call it compliance points, because this is a term that is currently used under BWI assessment clusters. So we have 11 compliance points, so you can say we have 11 environmental parameters that we are looking at. We can limit environmental management system, environmental training, air emission, ozone depleting substances, air emission, water, waste management, up to energy management, which includes greenhouse gas emissions as well. Well, not to confuse this with the chemical management component, because in some environmental assessment available out there, chemical management might be included under the environmental group. But as I said earlier, that this assessment is designed to be an additional component to the existing BWI assessment. In chemical management or hazardous material management is already included under the OSH cluster under BWI assessment. So we are not including it again, or we are not reintroducing it again here. Just a slight comparison between the BWI environmental clusters that we develop and propose to BWI in comparison to proper assessment. As what Sigit mentioned earlier, that under proper program we have different ratings, so each company can actually try to achieve a different level of environmental compliance depending on what rating do they want to achieve. So on the other hand, the BWI environmental cluster assessment that we develop, we don't separate that into different ratings. So we are going to assess the factories or the companies for all environmental parameters regardless. So one of the key difference here is, if I can introduce you, is environmental management system, or EMS. Environmental management system is actually not yet mandated in Indonesia under the Indonesian law, but it is actually introduced in a proper rating for the beyond compliance rating. So that's a difference. So if we are going to assess a practical factory, we will still include EMS, or environmental management system component, as a prerequisite. So, you know, as any other type of environmental assessment, we will work with questionnaire. This is again similar to the existing BWI assessment. We have questionnaires. This is just an example of what the questionnaires look like. So we developed, I think, over than 50 different questions to cover all of those 11 compliance points or environmental parameters. This is just two examples that we took. One example from the environmental management system point and one example from the wastewater component. This is just want to show you that the unique component of the BWI environmental cluster assessment is that it is designed to ensure and to make the factories prepared to meet two different levels of compliance. One is the Indonesian environmental law and regulation requirement, which includes, in this case, proper requirement, but also we want to incorporate a different level of requirement here, which is from the international standard. So in our questions, in our questionnaire, we also include the requirement under the IFC performance standard or also from the World Bank Group EHS guideline. So in this case, it's very, the reason why I say it's very unique because we want to make sure that the factory can meet the Indonesian requirement but also can try to meet the possibly the buyer's requirement that we try to reflect that from the IFC or the World Bank Group EHS guideline. So a quick look at how the questionnaire might look like. We have compliance points at the first column. This is pretty much going to be the 11 environmental parameters that I mentioned to you earlier. And we have questions and guidance notes. The guidance notes basically describe what the question actually looking for from the factory. So we actually have done, ESC has done the pilot assessment recently into three different factories, which particular of the factories we are not able to disclose. But I just want to convey key message from what we saw on the site, which is quite interesting at one point, because based on our research that garment factories has not been participated or has not actually joined any of the proper programs so far, as as Sigurd mentioned, textile companies, textile factories have, but garment factory actually have not joined any of the program, a proper program recently. So this is just the general results of what we saw on site. So out of those 11 compliance points or 11 environmental parameters, nine of which were applicable to the factories that we visited. The two compliance points which were not applicable were the ozone-depleting substances and the energy management, which includes the greenhouse gas emission requirement. So while these nine components here were applicable and we observed some non-compliances to both Indonesian requirement as well as the requirement from the IFC performance standards or the World Bank Group EHS guideline. I will not go very detailed one by one, but I'm just going to showcase the main point here. Almost all the factories that we visited, they did not have or they had not yet established the environmental management system. So we can say they did not actually have a specific environmental policy. For instance, policy in water conservation, policy in waste management. This might be true because, again, as I say, EMS is not yet mandated in Indonesia, but for companies who want to go slightly beyond the compliance, and I'm sure in most of the buyer's requirement, EMS is actually one of the key components because it actually is the foundation of the environmental performance of a particular company or factory. So we saw that this is basically a very classic case that we found in each of the factory, no EMS available, and that led to all other non-compliances findings that we saw inside, including we observed that there is no comprehensive environmental training program as it is in the factories. They might have already had OSH-related training program, but not so much on the environmental component. Regarding permitting requirement, for instance, we also saw that one or two of the factories that we visited, they did not actually have a proper permitting to abstract the groundwater for the on-factory or on-site water use, or some of the factories have already obtained that permit, but the permit is already expired and not yet been extended. We also observe some findings from the waste management practice, like they actually have, they call it temporary hazardous waste storage area, but either they have not identified a proper company to actually take the hazardous waste out from the factory, or they haven't actually obtained the permit to actually store that hazardous waste. So those are pretty much the basic of the Indonesian requirement here, that if they don't actually comply with those requirements, once, let's say, the Minister of Environment knock on the door and they say, please join this year proper program, they will not be able to even meet the blue rating requirement in this case. So I wouldn't use the word wake-up call, but this is somehow like a wake-up call that actually there are a lot of improvement to be made in terms of the environmental management performance on garment factories in Indonesia, based on the assessment that we did in the three factories. So we also want to make a comparison between the BWA environmental cluster assessment that we developed with proper program, as well as another assessment which is available out there, which is called the HIC index. A little bit more about the HIC index. I'm pretty sure that maybe some of you have already been familiar with the HIC index. This is actually self-assessment sustainability performance tool, which is developed under the Sustainable Apparel Coalition, or SAC. Some companies might have already been a member of SAC, so this may be not too a strange word for you guys. So HIC index itself cannot be considered as a compliance tool. Why is it so? Because it is designed not to specifically target a particular country environmental or social requirement. Well, and the difference is, under proper NBWI environmental cluster assessment, these two programs are designed as a compliance assessment tool. In this case, proper is designed to make sure that the factories being audited will meet the local Indonesian environmental requirement, while in the environmental assessment that we developed for BWI, we have an additional component in that, which we also want to make sure that the companies or the factories will meet the international requirement. In this case, it's reflected by the IFC Performance Standards requirement. The application of this assessment, HIC index, the HIC index version 2.0, which is recently launched a few months ago, has been designed to be implemented to apparel and footwear industries, while the environmental cluster assessment that we developed for BWI is supposed to be designed to be implemented to the apparel industry, or the garment industry in this case. A slight difference in terms of the application for proper program, actually there is no limitation in terms of the industry where the proper program is implemented. Under the Indonesian environmental regulation, proper is advised for all companies which are environmentally sensitive, as well as any companies which is seeking for listing at the stock market. And the third parameter is quite interesting. It's about audit or validation requirement. So under the HIC index, there is actually no requirement for the factories to do a verification of their self-assessment. So the HIC index is simply a checklist tool, questions that the factories can answer for themselves, but there is no requirement under the HIC index for these factories to go out and seek for a third-party company or a third-party verifier to ensure that what they declare is indeed true or correct. So while this is not the case under proper and BWI environmental cluster assessment, because under proper, as we have seen previously, that there is a government technical team who will do an environmental inspection that will come up with a particular rating, while the environmental cluster assessment that we designed for BWI require a third-party international environmental consultant, in this case like ESC, to come into the factory to do the verification of their work. We will do a site visit, we have site walk around, making sure that everything that they declare on the paper is indeed true or correct. comparison in terms of the assessment scope, it's quite a little, pretty much all the three assessments are quite similar. HIC index actually covers both environmental and social labor. The BWI assessment itself has already covered the social labor as well as the OSH component, so the addition of this component, the environmental component in it, will make this assessment become as comprehensive as HIC index. While PROPER itself pretty much highly focused on the environmental aspect with a little bit of addition in terms of the social component when they want to achieve a higher rating or beyond compliance rating, in this case either green or gold. Last but not least is the comparison in terms of the result publication. We, as previously mentioned under the PROPER presentation, that any results of PROPER assessment will be publicly disclosed annually. So if you go to the website of the Ministry of Environment PROPER portal, you will see names of the companies that get audited every year, what type of industry are they working at, as well as the final rating, either it's black, red, green, gold, or green. So public disclosure is a quite significant portion of PROPER assessment. While this is not the case under HIC index and our environmental assessment that we develop for BWI, that any results from this assessment will only be disclosed to the factories or the facilities, and to a certain extent it will only be disclosed up to the buyers, subject to the approval and agreement between the parties. So I think this is pretty much the practice that is currently being done under the labor and the OSH assessment. Any results will only be disclosed to the interest parties, the buyers, as well as the